Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will continue with the same lesson, major landforms. In the last lecture, I have completed the landform mountain, types of mountain and importance of mountain. Today I will continue with the plateau. Plateau is also one of the major landforms. Now what is plateau? Plateau is an elevated landform with a flat top and a steep slope. Now children, again plateau. Plateau also you have studied in 4th standard in detail. So it is an elevated landform with a flat top. Means it is little bit, it is an elevated, it is not like a mountain, but it is elevated landform with a flat top with a steep slope. Means again the it is having a steep slope and it is little bit higher from the nearby area. Now children, the large in when we will refer to our physical map of India, most of the Deccan part, that is the most of this southern part of India is covered with the peninsular plateau. This part is mostly having the plateau region. Plateau means plateau. Now this part of India is mostly covered with the plateau region. Now children, most of the continents have the plateau region, and the surface of the plateau is cut off by the rivers. Now many rivers flow through the plateau region. Now children, in the 4th standard we have studied that the triangular shape, the plateau, Deccan plateau is of in the triangular shape, and river Narmada divides the plateau into two parts. River Narmada divides the plateau into two parts, Deccan plateau and southern plateau. Large part of Asia, South Africa, North America and Australia have the plateau region. When we will refer to the world map, we will see that the large part of Asia, South Africa, North America and Australia have the plateau region. But when we refer our India map, we will see that this most of the southern part of the India is covered with the plateau region. Now children, the plateaus, let us see what is the importance of plateau. Plateau is rich in minerals. That means this area, when we see Malwa, this side we have Malwa plateau, Chota Nagpur plateau. Again the Deccan plateau is divided into two parts, Malwa plateau and Chota Nagpur plateau. This is the southern part of the plateau. Now this Deccan plateau is mostly rich in minerals, and then good for cattle rearing and the sheep. Why it is good for cattle rearing and sheep? Because of its grassland. These plateau regions are mostly covered with the grasses, and so these grasslands are used as the cattle rearing and sheep rearing also. Then black soil, mostly in the plateau region we see the black soil. We found the black soil, and black soil is fertile and very good for cotton and sugarcane. So mostly in the plateau region we have the cultivation of cotton and sugarcane. So this is about the plateau region. So once again I will repeat children, what is plateau? Plateau is an elevated landform with a flat top and a steep slope. Now children, mountain is higher. It is having a steep slope. It is having a pointed peak and a broad base. Now plateau is, it is elevated but it is having with a flat top and a steep slope. So I have given you, I have explained you with the help of our India physical map. So this is about the plateau region. Now let us move towards the plains. What is plain? A plain is a land with relatively low relief. Now children, India, that is from Jammu Kashmir in the north to Arunachal Pradesh in the east, we have the mountain ranges, three parallel mountain ranges. And we know here we have the Himalayas, and when the Himalayas are covered with the snow, and when these snow melts, the river flows through the mountain valleys. And when these river, these Himalayan rivers, when they flow from here, they enter the plains, they enter to the earth's surface, and they form the northern plains. And when these Himalayan rivers, when they flow through the plains, it is a plain means it is a land with a relatively low relief, children, because when these rivers, when they flow through the plains, they enter to the low relief, making these plains more fertile. Because the Himalayan rivers, when they flow, they carry sand and silt with them, which makes the land fertile. And children, see here, from here you can see just below the Himalayas, these mountain ranges, this part is nothing but the northern plains. Plain means totally flat relief, which is good for the crop cultivations and all, where we can see the human life. Children, we see the different landforms on the earth, mountains, plateaus, plain, but the life is very easy and possible on the plain surface. Children, on the mountains, life is very difficult, but on the plain relief, the life is easy. So children, this is about the plains. Now, plains are also called the lowlands because they are on the plain surface. Now, what is the importance of the plain, children? Plains have the fertile soil. It is not like that these areas, this part of India doesn't have the plain area. Plains, they have the plains, but this northern part of India is very fertile. Northern plains are very fertile. And in the life, we are not talking only about the northern plains, but everywhere, wherever we have the plain, wherever we have the low relief, low lands, life is easy. Therefore, the settlement and the life is easy. People can easily settle on the low relief, whereas people will not like to go and settle on the mountain peaks or on the plateau regions, because that condition, life conditions are very difficult. But on the low land, life is easy. Then easy to construct the roads, railways, aerodromes, industries and houses. It is very easy to do all these constructions on the low land, children. Whereas on the other landforms, it is very difficult. It is not like that the human settlement is not there. Human settlement is there, but the lifestyle is very different and difficult. So this is about the plains. Now children, plains, when we compare with the other landforms like mountains and plateaus, life is very easy on the low lands, the plains, that is. So we say that the plains are thickly populated than the mountains and the plateaus. If I will ask you, you go and stay on the mountain, will you like it? No. And so the plains are thickly populated because it is very comfortable to settle on the land. And also, children, the agricultural activities are very comfortable and easy on the lowlands because the soil is also fertile. The soil on the mountains and the soil on the plateau regions are not fertile for the agricultural activities. And so the crop production can be easily done. The construction of the roads, railways, aerodromes, houses can be easily done. And so the life is very comfortable on the low lands. So today we have completed the third landform, that is the plains. Now I hope you have understood why we are living on the low land and not on the the mountains and the plateau regions. Now children, this region of our India is plateau region. It doesn't mean that the human life is not there. Human life is there, but the conditions, for example, the agricultural activities, the lifestyle, everything is different. So we can say that the living conditions also changes with the landforms. Okay children, so today we have completed about the plateaus and the plains, and in the next lecture we will continue with the another landforms. So today I will stop here. Read the landforms, plateau and plains, and also read the mountains again carefully. Thank you.